Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Dhiriyat. Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 2nd Canto, 2nd Chapter, verse number 30. So in the previous verses we read how a yogi, he travels to the higher planetary system and reaches to the planet of Brahma. And that planet of Brahma, which is called Satya Loka or Brahma Loka, sometimes Parmeshti Padam, this is the highest planet in this material world. And after that there are coverings. So then he described how he crosses the coverings. Covering of earth, water, fire, air, ether, and the five tanmatras. Then when he has crossed all this, then comes the biggest covering, and that is the covering of ego. So this is a very big covering, and there are a lot of things in it. So about this, there are many things which are dissolved in it, and this particular verse is describing that. Says sabhut sukshmendriya sannikarsam manomayam devamayam vikaryam sansadya gatya sahatena yati vijnana tatvam guna sannirodham. So then he reaches the next element, which is called vikaryam here. Vikarya literally means that which brings transformation. Vikar. There is sanskar. You know what is sanskar? Means to improve something, to purify. And then there is vikar. Vikar is just opposite of sanskar. These days what you see in the universe, in the world, is all vikar. Everything is leading to vikar, polluting. Everything is a pollution. All these discoveries, they are taking us away from the originality. So what is the real cause of all this vikar is this ego. Ego brings the maximum number of changes. All the different types of vikaras, transformations, changing from originality, they are caused by ego. So therefore ego is verily called here in Sanskrit as vikarya, who is the source of all different types of changes in society. Without ego, nothing happens. Whatever you do, because change has to be done by somebody, whether it is a new invention or new production or new work, then it is caused by ego. Those people who are free of ego, they don't do anything. And those who have big ego, they do big works. So if you see all these people like, say, Hitler or Napoleon Bonaparte, or who was in Italy?
Mussolini.
These are all people of big ego. That's why Hitler said that you can cross the Alps. Who says it is not possible? Said impossible. He is the one who said impossible is a word in the fool's dictionary. And he made people go through it. So this is a work of big ego. Those who don't have ego, they will just sit. So big ego people do big works, big vikar, big changes, big transformation. And those who don't have that, they sit quietly. They become yogi. They're not interested in this. So when the yogi reaches this element, ahankar is also an element. There is a real ego, identification of the soul, and there is a covering of material ego. So this material ego is the cause of all changes in this world. So when he reaches there, then he dissolves the elements, all these tanmatras. Now he was going into each of these tanmatras, then these tanmatras, they are dissolved into the tamas, ahankar. And the senses, they are dissolved into the rajas, ahankar. And mind, along with the presiding deities of the senses, they are dissolved into the sattvic ahankar. The ahankar, the ego, has three divisions. Ego in the mode of goodness, that is more peaceful, divine, and ego in the mode of rajas, all the action, the senses are there, and all the elements, they come from tamas. So the yogi, he dissolves all this. Bhuta means the material element, sukshmendriya means this senses, working senses, knowledge gathering senses. Sannikarsam means they are dissolved. And then there is manomayam and devamayam. That is the sattvic ahankar. Vikaryam sansadya gatya sahatena yati. Then along with this ahankar, he reaches the next one, that is called vijnanatattva. Vijnanatattva is same as mahatattva. That is the intelligent, cosmic intelligence. Everywhere there is intelligence, because everything comes from mahatattva. So, because without intelligence, nothing happens. So, ego can be dissolved by intelligence. Because with intelligence, you can discriminate. So then this ego goes into vijnan tattva. Vijnan means knowledge, intellect. And then this intelligence is also material. Then it goes into pradhan, the prakriti, gunasan nirodham, where all the modes, they go and sit quietly. So there is prakriti, which is made of three modes. So it is like three virus. And they are sleeping, then it is prakriti. And when they wake up, it is called pradhan. They open their eyes, then they look at each other, then they start playing. Then first thing comes is intelligence. Then comes ego. Then all the mind, senses, elements, tanmatras, the whole thing comes.